Derek,
this.
Derek,
you're the greatest.
Thank you. You too, bud.
Well, this song here is just
really, you know, everything.
The song here is called just same thing, like you hear an old song on the radio, or you're somewhere and you hear a band play a song, and it just brings you back to a time. So that's what a song can do. So when I first got the, because as we're going along, you pick up instruments. I started off playing guitar, so then I got the mandolin. I like to diddle away. So I was like a little cabin in a place called the Antioch Mountains. That's halfway when you're coming down Bridger Road there, the rocky crevices that's there on the road. So it's just a little instrumental. And this is what it's called, Antioch Mountains.
Anyone in a catamaran probably didn't see the Antioch Mountains. They're pretty cool. We like up there in that way.
We should jump,
man. Yeah, we jump. We do a lot of backcountry skiing up here, and snowmobilers go up there in the winter, and it's beautiful.
It's beautiful, yeah.
Rugged Mountains, right? A punk song, no?
Actually, it's got a bass and punk, yeah.
It's a punk band called Days and Days, but it's a folk punk. So it's a little team. And we got Celtified a bit, so Celtic folk punk.
We got a Newfoundland a little bit, yeah.
This is a love song, so it's pretty.
Turn me up,
please. Pretty nice.
Thank you.
punk song.
And again, same with this instrument. I got this one. My wife bought me this for Christmas a few years back. And I started dabbling with it, so this little melody came out, and it just reminded me of when you're out kayaking, it's really early morning, there's not a ripple on the water, and you're just kind of paddling. It's just a really calm, nice morning, right? So we just call it morning paddle. First thing came to my mind.
Is sort of about the environment. It's one I wrote several years ago, but it's about what it was like around here, probably 1,000 or even 2,000 years ago. Now picture this area.
Before Tim Hortons.
Before Wi-Fi. Just imagine the people that lived here 2,000 years ago, and so it's kind of a tribute to those people, the Eskimos and the Indians and the prehistoric people. It's called Man of Wild. Beside you stands a child. watches and he learns. Tool traditions and a dad. Deep Eric Woods, they're from Manitoba. Kind of a folksy, like an old, you got some country, I don't know what it is, lovely stuff.
Yeah, great stuff. Anyway,
real uplifting. This is, it's called All the Money I Had Is Gone. True story.
Change it up again.
I'm gonna take me egg if he's starting to sweat. He's I'm sorry,
boy, man.
Starting to get egged off.
Yeah.
When I was growing up, I never used to remember words. I just used to remember music. I don't know if anyone used to do that. I just used to listen to the music and never sang very much. So now when it comes to retaining words, things that aren't lost. So I can't even remember my own song. So that's why I wrote, it's called, just sitting back and taking a breath. That's all it's about. It's called sitting in the shade of a tree. Song about Newfoundland's flower, the pitcher plant. Just seemed to come together when we wrote it.
Yeah, this is what made me cry. It is awesome.
Yeah. A little different than the last one. So.
Thank you.
Ways to Bog, yeah. Thank you, Tom. Writing this out.
Now I'm going to screw up on a Derek song.
This is a song I wrote many moons ago. It's called Swift Away. Should I or should I not turn Tom up? Do you want not to hear Tom? Just give her a little strum, see what I got here now.
I have plenty.
That okay?
Yes, yeah.
Inside of her hand is an illusion. She's the instrument.
know. This is how do we end this?
Want to try Old Brown and Daughter?
Sure, yeah. I'm going to try one more, I guess. Then you zog out going a little bit. I'll try Old Brown's Daughter. Old Brown's Daughter. You know that one, eh? Yeah. Yeah, you are. Hey?
Like your socks, too.
Thank you. Yeah. Yeah, that's a neat old tune, Old Brown's Daughter. Who wrote that, does it?
Old Brown?
Yeah, Mr. Brown.
Yeah, John Wheat on here. They all wrote it. We're not going to do the John Wheat version of it. Keep it going. Pretend like I'm not here. So whoever done it, it's three or four of us. When I forget the words, I feel you, okay? Normally I would say wheelbarrow if I forget a word, but a lot of my songs have wheelbarrows. Thank you. Guaranteed to make you leave, no? It's another punk song.
Gotta turn you down, turn you up.
Don't matter.
Don't matter.
Not mad. Turn yourself down so I can bang on the guitar a bit.
One more?
No, we're done. I'll set you so cute. Now you know.
Wait, hey?
You want to play on this?
No, well, she don't have one, so.
All right.
Oh, I can. Something.
Hey?
Cold Missouri Mountains.
I try it. Try it.
You play it, play.
Okay, let's try it. Well, you play along with me.
I'll always suck you up.
Try one more, and that's it. That'd be it.
That's a really pretty song. Just give me the lowdown to the song. Here.
Yeah, this song is about a forest fire in North Montana back in 69, was it?
49.
Could you smack that fella behind you? this is called Cold Missouri Waters. And the chief of the fire crew survived the fire. But a lot of there's 13 men died, and they kind of tried to pin the blame on him, right? What he done, he lit his own fire, and he lit down in to try to get his men to come into the fire that he lit. But they wouldn't listen because everybody was panicking, and he lit into his own grass fire and survived. And everybody else got burned, right? Well, he died. Cold Missouri Waters. Was this one we got in on happier note than this. This is this is trickery.
Damn
you.
Running out of time, tried to tell them, step in
said, you can't make it. This is the only chance you'll get. But they cursed me, ran for the rocks above me and said, I lay face down afraid of cold Missouri water. Old Missouri waters, 13 crosses I bow, old Missouri shores.